It was time for one last get-together of the best players in the state. Bismarck hosted Game 3 of the Shields East vs. West All-Star Game. The West won Games 1 and 2 last night in Fargo. In the bottom of the third, the West were looking for something. They were down 3-1, but Bailey Berg hits it towards Mara Lick, who snags it off her shoelaces. It was an excellent play there, and she makes the throw over for the double play. Then, after scoring two runs earlier in the inning, the East would tack two more on when Elizabeth Newell, she hit this ball up the first baseline, and the East take a 7-1 lead. That wouldn't quite be enough, though, because the West would rally back. They would actually take the lead in the bottom of the frame. Ellie Braddon grounded that ball up the middle, and that brought in Bailey Berg. The West, they would go on to win in extra innings 10-9. With the boys Class A state golf tournament taking place on opposite sides of the state, the best high school golfers in North Dakota have gathered in either Wahpeton or Dickinson to have a go at this year's state title. The Class A tournament is out in Dickinson at Heart River Golf Course. On the second hole, Century's Anders Alms, he finds himself deep in the rough here. He hits it. It comes close to right at the edge of the green, and it's just far enough for him to get par on that one. Minot's Brock Jones found himself in that same spot deep on the rough, but his second go landed it right on the green, and he would finish just short of the hole as well. Grand Forks Red River Carson Skypergod pipes this ball up about 60 yards away from the pin. His shot didn't have any backspin, and it rolled just far on the back of the green. His birdie putt would go a little long, making it a challenging putt for par. Cheyenne, they have a 15-stroke lead in team scoring, with Red River 15 strokes behind them. Century and Jamestown sat tied for third, and in individual leaders, it's all Cheyenne at the top. The top 10 is filled with golfers from the East. Legacy's Matthew Souther, he sits in eighth, shooting at 74. The B tournament, it was out east in Wahpeton. We start on the back nine holes. This is on the Minnesota side of the course, and some solid play early from Shiloh Christian's Wyatt Weston. This shot goes right up on the green on the 12th hole, and it's a tough putt right after, but it will fall right in. He nails the par on that one. We'll circle back to the 10th hole now as Everett Ducek from Beulah. He's going to hit this one up the fairway. It skips on up through the rough grass all the way right to the edge of the green. It's a nice little drive right there, and he's within sight of the hole. He's going to get the ball oh so close to the hole. He'll knock it in for par on four. He led his group this whole hole, and on the same hole is Braxton Ryan of Napoleon Gackle Streeter with the long putt. This comes just within inches of the hole. It's an easy knock-in to continue his good play of the day. The Squirrels have a lead in team play. Central Class sitting there at the top with Oak Grove, Kindred, and Shiloh right on each other's heels. Aiden Hall and Zachary St. Uben are tied for first at one below par in the individual scores, with many other golfers still in the running looking forward to day two. In baseball scores around the area, the Twins dropped their first game on the road to the Rays. The Larks handle business against the Moondogs in Mankato. The Big Sticks dropped their series opener in Casper against the Spuds. And in Legion baseball, the Mandan Chiefs do the double over the Dickens.